I gave AI access to 36 Revit tools to read models. Most AI chats for Revit create and run code from scratch, making sometimes small errors. But this is different. AI works with my small tools and react to Revit feedback. So let's jump into Revit. So I got this model over here, so I'm just gonna run the AI connector. Basically, the first time I run it, it's going to automatically set up everything for me. I just may need to restart Claude if it was open at the time of running the connector. But if not, I just need to open it. Apart from that, what this is gonna do is gonna actually connect Claude to Revit and use some of the tools that I provided. So once it's connected, you should be able to see the tools over here. If you don't see them here, it's because you need to restart it or you need to actually do the admin thing. Connector only works for Revit 2025 and 2026. Basically just ask, for example, select the three smallest floors in Revit. How fast it runs, it's gonna depend on what Claude. Sometimes runs faster, sometimes takes a little bit shorter. So I also use sometimes cursor, which is quite fast to run. As you see, it's running the logic, first get some category, then get the elements, then looks for the parameters, and then it's gonna select the elements that has the smallest area. So that's one workflow. Let's see if it ends up. So I'm getting all the responses from Revit here. I see that three floors has been selected, the three smallest. So that was one of the workflows. So another workflow, for example, I can say like, I think this model actually has some warnings. Let me see, it has some warnings. So I can say, let me go back here. I can say, select the floors related to warnings and explain me what the warnings are about. So it's actually key to provide as much context as possible. Like sometimes the AI don't know what you're talking about. So if I don't say, for example, that I want to have an explanation about the warning, I may just not have it or things like that. But also about the elements, if we say that an element is a floor or a family, it also helps the AI find the element faster and to use the proper tools for that. So first it's gonna get all the warnings and then it's gonna get the categories from elements IDs. It's gonna check the categories of the elements and then keeps checking and then it sets the user selection. And then it's gonna obtain some information, I think, to reply to me about the question that I asked. So it's getting some parameters. And then I have all the info. So yeah, it's like the floors basically overlap. So there are two floors over here. It selected both of them. So that's pretty cool for selecting using parameter values and to select elements under different conditions, families, and so on. Something else that I can do that I like is making reports. So I can say like make nice graphs and charts about the different floor types, their number of elements and their material structure. So when it has to generate like a little bit more complex documents or charts, it takes a little bit longer. It's first getting all the information and then it will generate the report, creating all the code and so on. So let's see, gets element types for element IDs, get materials. I think I'm gonna fast forward all this and then from the results. Great, so I got the report. This time was pretty straightforward and some explanation as well. sometimes make small errors, so it's not perfect. Sometimes it needs to try one or two times to get the report done, but in this case was done straight away. So I got the elements, let me hide this. So I got the elements per floor type. These are the number of elements for each floor type. Then I got the total area distribution based on the floor type, the floor thicknesses of the different floor types, average area. Wow, that's a lot of information actually. I didn't expect that much. So, and then all the materials that are used for the different floors. So we got like generic fill, it's not compound. Then we got carpet finish, which has carpet, plywood, structure, and then wood joists, well, all the information there. And one cool thing about the reports is that we can actually publish them. So I can click here, and that's gonna publish the report into a website so I can share it with whoever I want. So I click in publish, and then I got a link that is public, and then copy the link, go into the web browser, and then I got the report straight away. So that's it. I mean, there is a lot of like different use cases, different things that we can ask, but I think this overall summarizes quite well. It's running, as I said, only 2025, 2026, but still working on new tools and new things that it can do. So I hope you like it, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.